gospel of is that we need to have, watch this, we need to have some spiritual power. How many of you have spiritual power? How many of y'all can say the things I used to do I ain't gonna do no more?
Amen. Amen.
That's spiritual power. We can control whatever the inner man wants to do. I'm winding up. Spiritual power. Growing. Spiritual power. Thing that I need to have. You need to have some power, because if you're controlling what's bothering you, then you get to be able to see what's in Romans 8 and 1. See what it says.
Therefore, some of no condemnation. Spirit.
That power, right? All right, now watch verse 2.
Watch it, Doc.
Read verse 2.
For the law of spirit of Christ Jesus
made me free from sin and death.
Wow.
Did you ask the question, who will deliver you?
Yes.
You got the power.
You got the power.
What happened to Jesus when he died?
All about sin.
Huh? What happened to him on that Sunday morning?
Oh, got up from the grave.
The same power that got him up, you even got it in you.
Yes.
How many of y'all know you were dead in your sin? Dead.
Just dead.
When sin is controlling you, you are dead. Dead. That's what killed Jesus, didn't it? Sin. And sin will kill our young folks. Sin will kill a marriage. Sin will kill a church. Sin will kill a family.
True that, true that.
So you need to have some spiritual what?
Power.
And the verse says you got it, right?
Yes.
I said, read verse 2 again. It's loud. I ain't fooling you. It's loud.
For the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus have made me free from the law of sin and death.
I'm already free. I don't need to worry about it. Stop worrying about when you make a mistake. You got the power to bounce back. This ain't gonna cost you nothing. This ain't costing you one dime. Same stuff. Somebody paid me. You get it for free. Same power. Can't nobody bind you down. If you can get your inner man under control, you can control anything else. And Jesus, that verse said, you what? Is it there? Can y'all spell free?
It's free.
Spell it for me, because you ain't gonna have
F-R-E-E.
Yeah. You're free. That's why you come to church. You wanna feel like you're somebody. You wanna feel like you're free. You don't have to wallow in the mud. You hear the old preacher say, you can take a pig or a hog, wash him up, put a bowl on him, put him in the house, but you let him back outside, you're gonna find the next mud hole and water him.
Still a pig.
You don't have to do that. You're what? Free. The question is, who's going to deliver me from these two people on the inside? Jesus has already done it.
Yes.
Can you raise hold of hand? I mean, y'all feel free.
Amen.
I sure am free.
Amen.
I feel free.
You leave here this morning, you don't have no excuse. No excuse.
No excuses.
I didn't do it. The Bible said Jesus did it, didn't he? And we know he did it because if he could die on the cross for your sins and mine and then get up on Sunday morning and give you that same power. Same power. Look at the news. It's the same power.
Same power.
Same power. Same power.
You got it. Same power.
Same power.
Free. Now you can let the devil control you tomorrow. That's you. See, the devil know that sin is still there. He'll use it. He'll use it. But guess what? He can't use it without your permission. You got to have your permission because you are free. All right? That's why we need the church to remind us that we're free. That's why I don't like to miss. I need y'all to help me deal with whatever happened last week. Free. Okay, I'm ready to close now, but I want to remind you something. You're really free. You're really free. And really mean it. In that first part of that 25th verse, I got to have you to stand up and shout. Just the first part of that 25th verse. You are free. Y'all ready? That's it. Stand up. Come on, stand up. Let it know you're free. If y'all see what that first 12 or that 21st verse said, now say, shout it like you are free.
I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
All right, let's try it again.
I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord.